Absolutely. You know, I think we have to put an awful lot of things in perspective. When Dr. Kissinger first was involved in opening up China as a result of really the intermediary, Nicolae Ceaușescu at the time was the leader of Romania, it was a very different period. Joseph Biden had been a United States senator for 2 years. The relationship, certainly as far as trade was concerned, was absolutely minuscule back then. And things have developed in such a way that China has come a very long way in regards to, and the United States, in regards to the two-way relationship. Today we're dealing with issues that we never would have dreamt about back in 1974. The need for addressing climate change, dealing with a subject like chips electronically. These are all dramatic changes, and the evolution has been absolutely extraordinary. But the notion of stopping dialogue between the two superpowers of the world today is really infantile. It is something that needs to continue to be worked at. Clearly, the incident over the Chinese balloon was a significant moment in which it all of a sudden put a blockade in terms of the discussions between the United States and China. But sometimes I think even with two nations, whether it's China, the United States, or smaller nations, sometimes we need adult supervision to be able to say, look, there's an awful lot that's at stake here, and we have got, at the very least, to be able to talk with one another. You just mentioned, for example, the defense minister. Well, the United States, of course, imposed, when Donald Trump was president of the United States, sanctions against him for a variety of reasons. And so there are a lot of these kind of ticklish issues that have got to be addressed. And the best way to do it is obviously through dialogue. Delighted that Janet Yellen was there, John Kerry was there, Anthony Blinken was there. This is a start, and I think can only add to a much more positive relationship between our two countries.